jumping right back to the finger and hand and stick technique, finger control, I derive the first position for that from the actual first position, you know, where I hit the accented downstrokes and also the wrist strokes. So I'm just taking this and I curl it in 45 degrees until my thumb is actually facing the sky. If there's a roof, that's fine too, then face the roof. And the angle of the stick is kind of, it's a little parallel to the arm. It's kind of lining up with the arm right now. And I'm trying not to give up that gap, you know, that I don't want to have here. I'm trying to not give up that. So it's going to stay put. They're going to be close together. So what finger control is about is finger control. And we're going to control the stick with the fingers in that position. And what you have to watch with this is your wrist, because it's going to want to help and you shouldn't let it. So the first thing you can actually practice without a pad, you're just having two fingers, thumb and index finger, and try this in the air. So you see the angle I'm doing this in? In that view here. I'm trying to keep it really level, so as if it was a fan, you know, something. Not to have it bounce left and right so much. And again, it's between thumb and index finger. That's the most important part, because that's the pivot point that all the other control mechanisms with the middle, the ring and the pinky finger are gonna revolve around. So if I'm at the next finger, which I'm not yet, it's gonna be an exercise now in a second. If I'm here, these still have some work to do, passive work now, but the middle finger is going to revolve that stick around this point, around the pivot point that thumb and index finger are creating. And I'm still trying to maintain that gap. If I do this, just thumb and index, if I do middle finger, thumb and index will stay there. And then I do, without any of the other fingers touching, I do the ring finger, just in the air, just trying it out here without tempo or something, just getting a feel for it. And it should put some stress on the thumb here, because that's the muscle that we're actually training to, the fulcrum muscle, that's very useful. And I have a tendency to be thorough, so I go with the pinky as well. Although I might not use it so much when I really play, unless I really have that position, then I can reach it. But if I have a drum set position where this schooled kind of thing becomes more ear guided and I shape my sound with it later, then I might not even use that so much with finger control. But I like it. I think it's nice to have it going. So that's what I practice it with it. So without further ado, if you have toyed around with this for a while, you can freely move. I have the gap here now. I'm not happy. Ha! Okay, work in progress always, as everything is a work in progress. Isn't it lovely? So if you have toyed around with this for a while and you feel it, you feel some more control over the stick than at first when you do it. For me, it was wobbly, like I couldn't even get it in a straight line here. So, but after a while, that works out. So then I put a slow tempo on the metronome, obviously, and then I just bounce it. It's kind of bounce and fail. So again, this is where I take it from, the holding of the stick, and then I try to maintain a happy face and bounce it. Just thumb and index finger. It's really about the rebound, feeling it, and yeah, working it. Just taking it up there just with these two fingers. And do this for a while, don't do it fast. Slow is harder, but it will teach you so much more than fast, and fast is just fast, you know. So if you have this with the thumb and index finger, the next finger comes in, and the further you get to the back of the hand, like middle finger, ring finger, the harder it is to keep that gap closed, but we need that tension in your hand, so try it. And the harder it is to not let go of the stick. This one wants to let go, but we want to teach it how to catch the rebound. So you cannot let go. You have to be with it. Same with the paddles. You're not letting go of the paddles. You're going up and the paddle is following you, and you still feel the paddle on the upstroke, and then you feel it definitely on the downstroke. So same here. The stick bounces off of the surface, and I'm trying to, let me put this in slow-mo, my fake slow-mo that I love so much. I bounce it and the stick comes up and I'm giving way to it. I'm giving way to the stick with the finger, but not so much that I'm ahead of it and out of the picture already. You know, I want to feel it the whole time. That's the goal. And that's going to be what teaches your hand the most about how to bounce a drumstick. And then, as I said, the pinky finger is really tough to line up with all this. So you might want to try it still, but it is not easy. It teaches a lot here. So I just incorporate it. And then if you have it down and you're not totally frustrated by it going astray all the time, which takes a while, then you can up the ante a little bit and put it into like a slow 16th notes, really slow. Do 8th notes. 16ths are way too fast. And then you go one bar with thumb and index finger, one bar with middle finger actually doing the work, and thumb and index are just being the pivot point, one bar with the ring finger and one bar with the pinky finger, and then start at the top. Or incorporate the whole hand, which you can do also. And always watch the wrist. Wants to be a player here, not allowed to. So that's basic finger control, and I think you can derive a lot of exercises from this. Make new ones, put it in triplets if you know what triplets, you know. Do whatever you want with these. They're gonna last you a long time. Just do it slow, check out the motion first, and then go nuts. But make sure every finger, that's my strong suggestion, you know, I'm making this point over again. Do it slow and check out the motion, and then you can do whatever you want with it. You can just go nuts and make it your own. And it's on to the next one.